Hello my beautiful friends, it's Mimi here today and today's video is gonna be a little bit different. Today I'm gonna talk to you about something I wanted to talk to you about for the last 2 years, ever since I moved to London. I wanted to share with you about my experience of moving here, and at first I thought I need more time just to, you know, settle in and really experience living here before I give you any feedback or share any experience. And now it's been already almost 2 years. It's gonna be 2 years on July 17th this year, so I think I have enough experience to share. I want to tell you guys that it's been one of the best decisions I've made in my life. London is my third home. I was born in Baku, Azerbaijan. Then I moved to Toronto, Canada when I was 16 years old, and this is my third home, and it's been a really wonderful experience, so I can't wait to share it with you. So let's get started. All right, so I have my phone here where for the last 2 years I've collected notes about living in London, and I have all the pros and cons of living here, because just like any city, although I think London is the best city in the world, for me, I don't believe that it's the perfect city. I don't think a perfect city exists. You know, just like any city, London has good parts and bad parts, and I'm gonna talk about both. I'm gonna start with the positive because I always focus on the positive, and I'm just gonna first talk to you about how I got here. So how legally me and Alex moved to London. As Canadians, you can apply for different kind of visas, and we consider them. For us, because we have several businesses, we came here on a business visa. So it's something that you can apply through, you know, British Embassy of wherever you live. And if you're eligible, you have to spend a certain amount of money, then you will get accepted. But you actually have to come here, and when you live here, you have to employ people and you have to start an actual business. That's what we do. We have a creative agency here in London that does creative work for all the other businesses that we have. For example, Luxie Hair, 5 Minute Journal, we work on a few other businesses, and we also mentor a few other businesses. So that's what we do in London. So that's the visa we came with. However, if you're maybe, you know, interested in moving to London, I just want to mention right now that as a Canadian, US citizen, and Australian citizen, there's something that is called Youth Mobility Visa. I'm pretty sure US has it. I'm not 100% sure, but you'd have to double check that. So up to the age of 30, you can come and live in London for 2 years. So you can get any job, you know, based on your special, of course, and you can live here, you can travel, and if you're good and if you want to stay and your job sponsors you, then you can stay longer, of course. So that's a really cool thing. Of course, if you live in Europe, then you can just move here because you don't need any kind of paperwork. So that's how we legally got here. Adjusting to London was very easy this time. I mean, when I moved from Baku, Azerbaijan to Canada, it took me a bit of time to adjust, because although I knew English, I, you know, took English for years, when I came to Canada, it was hard to just get myself to talk. I was too shy at first, but moving to London was very easy because that's English is the first language here, and although I do not have a British accent, I had no problem adjusting and integrating with people and talking or anything. It just felt like being home. Another thing that I want to mention before I get into more details and more pros of living in London, I guess the reason of moving to London, because a lot of you always ask me, why did you move to London? It's very interesting. I think it's just the way I felt here when I first visited here. It was years ago, I think. Okay, let me just think about the days. It was about, probably before I started, because I've been dating Alex for 7 years, so this might have been like 8, 9 years ago. I came here with a friend. We were just traveling. We were just here for a few days, and I just remember just being somewhere on the street in London and feeling amazing, feeling like home. I actually never felt this way anywhere else in the world. I've traveled, you know, before moving to London as well. Never felt like this where I was born in Baku. I never felt like this in Canada. This was the only place ever where I just felt the sense of belonging, and also the sense that I'm gonna come and live here. Like, I just knew it. And I don't know, that feeling never went away. So I obviously went back to Canada. I was only here for a few days. And I just always remembered that I will someday come back and live in London. And then obviously when me and Alex started dating, I told him about it. On our trip here 2.5 years ago, me and Alex spontaneously decided to move here. We talked about it for a while. We were gonna actually come and live here for a month in the summer, but then we just said, you know, we're young, we don't have any children, why don't we just do it now? Because we've always been attracted to the European lifestyle, and we knew that, you know, living in Europe is something that we want to experience. So we just, you know, spontaneously decided to do that, even though we just bought a house before in Canada and we just finished renovating it. So when we went back to Canada, we sold the house and we packed our bags and we moved our life here. Alright, so back to the pros of living in London and why I love this city so much. I feel like this video is gonna be really long because I love it so much. Alright, so one of the biggest things I love about London is that I personally love living in big cities. I love people, I love being surrounded by people. However, I'm not really crazy about, you know, too much concrete jungle and too many streetcars and cars and just like that overall feeling of overwhelm that you have in a lot of big cities. And you don't feel that in London. So London is a big city. I always say that it's like it's a big city without a big city feel. We live in the West London, which is, you know, what you see in the movies, which is very beautiful architecture. It's all quaint and peaceful. Of course there's cars and there's people, but it just feels very peaceful. It doesn't feel like a big city. We travel a lot to New York, for example, and as much as I love New York, it's just a bit too, you know, go go go. It's very strong and it's very powerful and it's very moving. It's constantly moving, and here everything is just a bit more relaxed. There's no rush. And I love that because I am generally very go, go, go myself. You know, I'm very ambitious and I move really fast. So London slows me down and it makes me just enjoy the flowers and smell the flowers and enjoy life a bit more. So I really love that about London. Another pro of living in London, and I think this could be something personal, for me, I really appreciate beautiful architecture. I'm very aesthetic. So just living here and every day walking on the streets and seeing these beautifully designed buildings truly inspires me in a way that I can't even verbally explain. It feels really great to be surrounded by that. I feel if you're a creative person living in a place like, you know, Paris or London, can greatly inspire your work, and it can also provide such a beautiful backdrop if you're doing, you know, blogging, or if you're into photography, or if you're into video or any other kind of design work. There's just so much beautiful design and you can draw so many inspirations from that. So I really love that. Another pro of living in London is free museums, and I've never seen this anywhere else in the world, and I appreciate that so much here. I remember when me and Alex came here for the first time together, we went into a museum and we didn't pay anything and nobody said anything, and then Alex looked at me and said, wait, I think we just trespassed. You should just go and ask this person who works at the museum if we still need to pay. So I was kind of embarrassed, so I walked back and I said, do we have to pay a cover? Because we didn't. And the woman looked back at me and said, no, you don't have to pay. Museums are for the public. And I'll never forget that. It's just so amazing because to me, it shows that, you know, a country is highly evolved, because museums are open to wealthy and it's open to homeless. Like, anyone can go into a museum and be part of this beautiful art collected over, you know, centuries and centuries. It truly should belong to the public. I don't know why we have to pay for museums. I understand, of course, that museums need money to support them. And of course, there's big donation boxes and, you know, we make sure to donate so that they can keep going. However, it's just so beautiful to be able to just go into a museum, because, you know, you can't just go into a museum and spend the whole day. It can be very overwhelming and tiring. So we'll go to museums all the time for like just 10 minutes, half an hour, sometimes a little more, depending on the time. But it's just so easy to pop in, pop out, you know, have a date with a friend in a museum and then go on with your day. I think it's just a better way to even absorb the information that is in the museums. So huge bonus of living in London is free museums. Another pro of living in London, of course, for me, is all the green space. There is so much green space. I feel like I'm doing commercial for London. I promise I'm not. I just really love the city. For the first time in my life, I love the city where I live. And not to say that I didn't love Toronto, of course, or Baku, but like, I really, really, really love London. So I'm very passionate when I talk about it. I'm not trying to sell you on moving here. So I really love all the green space. We have Hyde Park, we have Richmond Park, which if you ever come to London, make sure to visit it. It's not very popular because it's a bit further away. You can take the tube to get there. It's like 30 minutes, I think, by train, or you can rent a car and drive there. It's like Africa. It's wild. There's like wild deer and you can really get close to them. It's just, it looks so beautiful. We have Regent's Park, there's Holland Park, there's all kinds of amazing parks. But the best part, guys, is that it's right in the heart of the city. Before, when I lived, for example, in Toronto, a lot of parks were a bit like away from the city, so you have to actually get in the car and drive to them. Whereas here, you know, you walk into the city, or you're walking like to Soho or like somewhere central, you can walk through the park. So a lot of times when we walk to central London, we just walk right through the park, and you get to walk, A, B, you get to go through the park and be in green space, which is so good for you, for your health. And yeah, you get to enjoy free parks. And on that note, another pro of living in London, and that's something for us, of course, because we live in the West London, and you know, we choose to live here and have maybe less space, but for us, it's very important that we walk every day. So we decided not to have a car when we moved here. We said we're not gonna have a car. We'd rather live right in the city and be close to everything. And if we need to get somewhere, we can walk. That's what we usually do. We can bike, you know, if the weather is nice, we usually bike. We can, of course, take public transit. I usually don't like the tube because personally I get very hot down there and it sometimes can be really crowded. I love taking the buses here in London, first of all because they're so cool and I always go upstairs, but also because I always feel like a tourist and I feel like I'm getting a free tour of London while I'm getting to my destination. Also, you know, so we walk everywhere. We take Uber sometimes. Uber is amazing, you know, because as soon as we moved to London, actually, that's when they launched, and Uber is actually like half the price of black cab usually if you take Uber X. I love it. If you've never taken Uber, take it. I'm gonna give you my code down below so you can get a free ride. But Uber has been amazing. So if it's late at night, we don't want to walk, then we take Uber. But usually, you know, for the most part, we walk everywhere, and I just feel like I don't even need to exercise as much because I'm getting so much exercise just, you know, going out, getting groceries, running my errands, or doing like day-to-day things. Another big pro of living in London, and that's something that I also love when living in Toronto, is that it's very multicultural. And not just multicultural, because in London it's also very cosmopolitan. And what that means is like there's a lot of people from all over the world, and they don't sometimes live here for the rest of their life. They're here to study or they're here because of some work project. So there's always all kinds of cool people doing all kinds of cool things, and they're here for some short period of time, or maybe they end up staying here, but there's all kinds of cool people coming and going, and you get to meet them, you get to collaborate with them if you want, and you know, you can learn from them. There's just an influx of really interesting people from all over the world, and I really, really appreciate that. I don't think that after living in Toronto and London, I could ever live in a place where it's just one nation. I really appreciate the fact where, you know, you can live in a city and you have all kinds of people from all kinds of cultures. You can learn from them, you can try their food. It's just such an amazing experience. It's like this melting pot, and I truly, truly appreciate that about London. Another thing I really love about London on that note is that I've had, you know, much deeper, better relationships in the only 2 years of living here, and I've made some amazing friends only in the last 2 years of living here, not even 2 years. More, way more, and way beyond of my 11 years, for example, living in Canada. Why is that? I don't really know. Personal thing, it's because first of all, I feel like London is just very extroverted city. It makes you an extrovert. If you're not, it will kind of push you in that way, because people like to socialize here. They don't spend so much time in their home. That's why they don't mind having smaller flats and small kitchen, because everyone goes out and they stand outside and talk on the street, you know, outside of the pub or outside of a cafe. It's all about being outside and being in the parks and just like enjoying what the city has to offer, as opposed to being indoors watching television, you know, being on your computer. So it's very extroverted. It's easy to meet people. Again, that's just my experience, of course. I don't know for other people, but I've just had such an amazing time meeting really cool people from all over the world and just having a blast. I've been loving it. Another huge pro of living in London is the quality of food, and I can't stress enough how important that is, because you know how they say you are what you eat. I totally believe that. You know, if you look at your body scientifically, you know, physically, you are made of the things you've consumed. So it was very important for Alex and I to live in a city where the quality of the food is good. And here in Europe in general, for now, and I hope it stays this way, GMO is banned, so genetically modified food is banned. You know, the quality of the crops, you know, is so much better, even if it's not organic food, although we do mostly buy organic even here in Europe. Even the non-organic food to me tastes way better than anything, you know, I've tried in Canada. So in my opinion, the food here tastes just way better. It's just the fruit and the vegetables have a lot more flavor in them. And again, when you compare England to Spain or Italy or France, then the food, of course, to me, when I travel to those countries, because of course there's more sun, it tastes even better there. But here in UK, I just find, you know, compared to Canada, for example, I find the quality of the food is a lot more fresher. It just tastes more real, you know, so I really enjoy that. I really, really appreciate that about London. One of my favorite things about living in London, of course, is the traveling aspect. Being based out of London makes travel a lot more affordable, B, a lot more closer, because there's so many countries around England that you can visit. You know, there's France, Italy, Spain, all of Northern Europe, which we haven't seen yet, but we're planning to. All of Southern Europe, Africa is only three and, well, Morocco, for example, so the beginning of North Africa is only 3.5 hours away. Everything is so close that it's hard not to travel, and we've really been enjoying that. I mean, that was part of the reason why we moved here. You know, business was first, of course, but, you know, doing this was the second point, is just to see more of the world. And you can literally just go away for the weekend and come back on Monday or Tuesday and just go back to work. Traveling is just a lot more flexible here. And another real cool thing about London for those who work and live here is that as somebody who works here, regardless of where your job is, you could be working in the office, supermarket, school, you get minimum of 20 business days holiday plus the stat holiday. So it all works out to like minimum 4 or 5 weeks of holidays. So people travel a lot here. They take a lot of holidays. They have time to live. I think that's really amazing that this country, especially, and you know, in Italy and Spain and France, it's even more. I think it's like 7 weeks minimum holiday. And you know, as you work in a company and you earn more holidays, some people even have 2 months holiday, like in Germany, I think. So it's really cool because it allows you time to just take a break, recap, recharge, and go back to work fresh. I really appreciate that about Europe, and you can really see that, you know, in the quality of the life here. And, you know, again, people travel a lot in Europe. They see more of the world than, let's say, people who live in North America, and I think that's super, super cool. So if you really want to travel, that could be one of the things you do. Just move to Europe for a few years and just, you know, work here, see the world. It's so much more affordable. It's not even funny. You can get flights for like as cheap as 30 euros or, you know, 20 pounds. You know, if you book ahead of time and you go with more of like an affordable airline, you can travel so frugally. You can stay in hostels. Traveling can be extremely affordable. Students travel, people who don't work travel, everyone makes it possible. Because a lot of people look at my, even my friends, they look on my Facebook and they're like, oh my god, you're such a jet setter. But here, I'm not that special. Everyone travels all the time. Another quick thing I want to mention is that the internet and the phone services here are extremely affordable to what I'm used to. For example, in Canada, I only pay for my plan here, and I have unlimited 3G and free internet and calling when I travel to most of Europe. When I travel to US, all of US, and a few other countries, it costs me, guess how much? 20 pounds, which turns out to be like maybe 35, depending on the rate right now, $35 for, you know, unlimited internet for phone and for using my phone when I'm traveling. It's just amazing. Before, in Canada, I used to pay over $100 for my plan, but here it's just amazing. So cheap. Every country should be like that. And the last pro I want to mention about London is that although London, you know, it's, or England, is just, it's an older country and it has so much history and culture, it doesn't really make you something. My friend Livia actually said it really well, and I want to kind of repeat it in her words, and she lived here for over 10 years. She said that London is sort of like a mirror and that you look into, and it just makes you more of who you already are. So it doesn't try to make you anything, it makes you more of who you are. And I truly feel that way. I don't feel like I've changed since I moved here. I'm just becoming more of who I really want to be and who I am. And now to the con part of living in London. And I thought really, really hard about the cons of living here. And I actually couldn't come up with many. I even asked some of my friends, I asked Alex, I'm like, what are some cons of living here? I really can't think of anything. Well, I can't think of one thing that always comes to my mind and comes to the mind of anyone who ever comes here to visit or lives here, is that London is super duper expensive. Rent is expensive, shopping is relatively expensive. I would say it's quite similar still to Canada. For groceries, shopping is more or less the same. Shopping for clothes is definitely more expensive. You know, another con is that the currency here is not euros, so it's pounds, and pound is really strong, especially right now. I believe the pound has gone up again, so it's like sometimes it converts to almost double if you make money in US, which we mainly, you know, because our business is in US, we make money in US, so living here is extremely expensive. And the reason London is such an expensive city, I think, is because everyone wants to live here. That's the thing. The population of London is incredible. increasingly growing. It's overpopulated, I think, and it's becoming even more overpopulated, especially since it joined the European Union. So people are constantly moving here to work, to live, and the rent is going more and more and more. It is expensive because people want to live here, so that explains the price point. And yeah, it kind of sucks that it's so expensive. However, we'll look at it this way. You only live once, and we'd rather live here, let's say, in a smaller space. Even though we live here in a smaller space, we pay way more than what we paid in Canada, you know, living in a house. But we don't mind that because we'd rather have a smaller space, but we'd rather, you know, travel more. It's all about prioritizing things that are important to you. You know, to some people it is important to have a big house and a big space. For us, it's important to travel and see the world and, you know, enjoy the parks and just enjoy the city. So I think the price is still kind of justifiable. However, it definitely is a big con about living here because it's horrendously expensive. I'm not gonna lie. However, I think it's definitely worth it. Another con, and that's a question that a lot of you guys always ask me, is do you miss your family? And frankly, I do. I do. I really badly do. That's the thing. Even before moving here, the reason it took me so long to move here is because I thought really hard about how am I gonna live without my family being in the same city with me. And it's very difficult, but it's possible. I think what's important is not to ever let attachments keep you from living your life and growing. Sometimes you need to move away to expand your mind, to grow and to change, because what travel does to you, or living in a different city, once you go there, you're never the same human being. Anytime you travel, or if you go and live in a city, which I highly encourage you to do sometimes, even to go do it for a year, you will not be the same person. Your mind would have expanded. You will grow as a human being, and I think it's an amazing experience. So I couldn't let the attachments I have with my family stop me from living my dream, and it was always my dream to come and live in England, or in London to be exact, because I, you know, I haven't lived in the rest of England. With that being said, I still try to see my family as much as I can. Luxy here is still based in Canada, so we travel there for business every couple of months. My family comes and visits me here. Of course, it's not the same. However, we make the best of our time together when we do see each other, and we try to chat, you know, Skype, or to be honest, I'm not a big Skyper, but we try to text message, and when we see each other in person, we just try to make the best of our time together. And that is it about living and moving to London that I wanted to share with you guys. I think this video is a bit long, however, it summarizes all of my experience. If you do have any questions about moving to London that I haven't covered in this video, then definitely leave me a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any other ideas or videos related to this, or any other videos that you want me to do where I get to sit and talk to you as a friend, then definitely leave me a comment down below and let me know what it is. I'd love to hear from you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you feel like ever moving into a city, I say go and do it. It's gonna be the best experience for your life. You know, people ask me, do you think you'll always live in London? I don't know. That's the thing, that's the beauty of life. Sometimes you have to go to a place and embrace it and grow and change, and then maybe you'll end up moving back to your home. It doesn't really matter, but I think it's really important to listen to your heart and allow it to guide you and lead you to wherever you need to be. So that's all I have for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.